This webinar explores a best practice approach for the integration of business process models and decision modeling in Enterprise Architect. Enterprise Architect 14 provides a tool suite for dynamically executing, simulating, and exploring such behavioral models. This webinar examines the mechanics of DMN and BPMN integration via three unique examples. The first example calculates sales from two departments. We demonstrate how to model a decision in Enterprise Architect, including building the DMN diagram and generating Java code based on that decision model. We also model the underlying business process in Enterprise Architect, which can use the generated Java code to make appropriate decisions. We use Enterprise Architect to simulate the expected delivery cost of furniture based on weight and price. We run a simulation that looks at 100 delivery costs using randomly generated values for both the cost and the weight. We use a new model pattern feature in Enterprise Architect 14 to build a completed example based on the DMN specification from the OMG. This example illustrates how modelable decisions can be modeled and connected within Enterprise Architect to establish complex decisions with multiple inputs and paths. You can even edit customer data, make comparisons, and see which path is taken through the business process based on different customer data. We shall begin by using Enterprise Architect to model a business process that will calculate the total sales from each department, in this case, Department A and B. The decision process for calculating sales and the underlying business process are modeled separately. So, if the decision process for calculating aggregate sales ever changes, say extra departments are added, or you decide to only take 80% of Department A's sales, it does not impact the underlying business process. Switching to Enterprise Architect, on screen we have created a simple business process to calculate sales containing a start event, an end event, and a single activity. Place the business process simulation artifact on screen so we can simulate the sales calculation using the BPSim execution engine. When you open the simulation, scenario parameters are displayed on the right of screen. The first thing we need to do is set the expression language to Java. You should also note that the JDK and JRE are set, because you need Java to run the simulation. It's important to note that BPSim is the Sparx systems implementation that allows the simulation of a BPMN model. I'm now going to create a class diagram to display the simulation artifact and the DMN configuration artifact. However, it could appear on either diagram. Note that I am drawing a dependency connector between the two artifacts. This is important because it tells Enterprise Architect that a dependency exists between the two models. In other words, the decision will feed into the business model, thus creating our integration. Our single BKM, or business knowledge model, is a literal expression that is used to add two numbers together. The next step is to generate our Java code from our decision model. Double-click the DMN simulation artifact to get started. Specify the path, namespace, and module name, then press Generate to build the Java code based on our decision. The system output window indicates that the DMN module has been successfully generated. Press the View button to examine the code in the Enterprise Architect code editor. The code is quite simple and the functionality basically adds two numbers that are stored as doubles. Now let's switch focus and return to our business process. We can now instruct Enterprise Architect to use the Java code we've just produced. The DMN is designed to model repeatable decisions, that is, decisions that you make more than once. At any time, we can alter the decision-making process and generate new code. In the business process, I'm adding a trigger count, which is used by the BPSim execution engine. I'll also add two properties to store the sales of Department A and the sales of Department B. I'm going to add a trigger count, which is used by the BPSim execution engine. I'm also going to add sales values for the various departments. Department A had sales of 25, while Department B had sales of 30. I'm using two constants, but you can also add statistical distributions and random numbers if relevant. On the activity entitled Calculate Sales, I want to add the sales of the two departments. However, I want to use a code from my decision model in order to undertake this work. I've created a new property called SumAB. In order to generate the value for the sum, I'm going to enter an expression. Simply press Ctrl plus space to use IntelliSense to automatically complete the expression. You can see I've selected artifact.addToNums. Using the Java code, we can add the two numbers function to return a meaningful result. You can see I am passing the parameters for department A and B to this function. We can now execute or run our simulation to see the result. As we step through the simulation to see how the results are calculated, you can see that the sales from Department A and B are listed as 25 and 30 respectively. Finally, you can see the sum of 55 is calculated accordingly. Our BPMN model has used Java code from our DMN model to calculate a decision and produce a meaningful result. This integration between business process modeling and decision model notation is a powerful feature found within Enterprise Architect 14. What is the benefit of modeling a business process and DMN separately in Enterprise Architect? If you combine your decisions with a business process in a single diagram, you often get a messy, complex diagram with far too many gateways. By modeling decision-making process separately to the business process, you get improved focus and clarity. It also allows you to edit a decision without impacting the underlying business process. Every time the rule changes for decision-making, say in frequent flyer programs, you can change how the rules are implemented, but you do not have to change the underlying business process. This in turn allows you to simplify the business process, making it easier to read and follow. You can eliminate any unnecessary gateways and focus on getting the process right. The integrated solution takes the decisions from one model and feeds them into your business process. You can reuse the process on multiple projects or test different decisions to find the optimal approach. Enterprise Architect even allows you to automate decisions to produce behavioral code. Let's take a look at another example to see the benefits of integration and simulation. Our next example uses a simple business process designed to calculate the cost of delivery based on the price and weight of the furniture. To generate the furniture price and weight, we use a random statistical distribution. This allows us to simulate the decision 100 times, which may be based on the typical number of customers a furniture shop can manage in a single day. The BPMN model on screen uses code from our decision model. You can see the function Delivery Cost Calculator is currently displayed on screen. If we switch to our DMN diagram, we can generate out the code for our simple decision that calculates a cost of delivery based on furniture price and weight. Each rule has been listed in our Java code, which could even be reused for a web-based application where customers could get a quote for their delivery price. The DMN module has once again been successfully generated and produced 99 lines of Java code. Our decision model uses a simple table to calculate the delivery cost. For example, if the price of the furniture is between $200 and $300 and the weight is less than 10 kilos, the delivery cost is only $5, as shown on screen in rule number 10. The U at the top of the table identifies that the table can only produce a single unique result. Once again, we have established a dependency relationship between our decision model and the corresponding business process. Now we can execute the simulation. You'll note that the trigger count is displayed in red as 100. In other words, we've calculated the delivery cost for 100 deliveries in a matter of seconds. We can now step through the simulation to observe the results. So if the price is $209 and the weight is 10 kilos, then the delivery cost is $5 based on rule number 10. Now, if we step through the simulation again, you'll notice that the token ID changes to 01, indicating a new customer has come along. This time, the delivery cost is $20, as outlined by row 8 of our rules. The next cost is $40 based on row 3. The model shown in this example could easily be adapted to parcels, packages, or any other relevant product transported by a courier. It illustrates how Enterprise Architect 14 can use a simple table to develop a complex set of rules. So, what are the benefits of using this approach within Enterprise Architect? The delivery calculator is a business process that has been modeled in BPMN. The BPMN is easy to read and does not contain any gateways or complex logic. The prices are in a simple table that both IT and business people can read and understand. You can test different decisions and rules to determine the optimum profitability. Decisions are easily changed without impacting the underlying business process model. The code can be reused even in a web-based application to generate delivery quotes, providing benefits beyond the simulation itself in automation and software reuse. For our final example, we need to apply a perspective. From BP Sim, select Apply Perspective. Select the completed model pattern, which is BPMN Integrate with DMN Complete Example. The model shown on screen come directly from the DMN specification from the OMG. Generate the Java code after you've selected a model path, namespace, and module name. Once again, the code has been successfully generated. There are 702 lines of code that have been produced from our complex model. You can validate the DMN to ensure that the module is compiled successfully and is valid. Once again, we have a relationship established between our BPSim artifact and our DMN simulation configuration artifact. One of the advantages of this particular example is that you can bring up the business process model and you can see what path has been taken through the business process model. The token is displayed in red once again. So for customer number 0, you can see that strategy is equal to through. So the attribute and value are displayed on the right hand side. I'm going to bring up a notes window. Another advantage of the completed example is that you can take the applicant data and you can modify it and instantly run the simulation and see what impact those changes have on the overall simulation. So now if I step through the simulation using the new data, you can see that a different path through the business process has been highlighted. Once again, if I step through, I can see that this time strategy is equal to bureau and routing is equal to decline. This real-time analysis of a business process is really quite valuable. The other advantage is you can see that Enterprise Architect has modeled multiple decisions and shown you how these decisions can have some kind of hierarchical structure employed. So, some of the advantages: you have the ability to quickly edit customer data and run a simulation. For more information about DMN, BPMN, or Enterprise Architect 14, please visit www.sparxsystems.com/EA14.